Okay, Doug, let's go to callers.
Let's head to Philadelphia. And Joe, you're on with Dr. Wallach.
Joe, you're on the air.
Doctor, thank you for taking my call, and also thank you for your courage and passion. It's so refreshing.
Hey, thank you. What's up?
I am 5'8". I weigh 200 pounds. I'm 49 years old. I'm hypothyroid. I have weak adrenals, foggy memory, low energy, frequent urination. Also have real bad allergies, including with food. And I have a lot of cravings, and my nose is constantly itchy. I have a very bad mucus problem. I know okay. I'm probably gluten-free. I've gone gluten-free because I know that's probably an issue for me. Mm-hmm. One last thing. I've tried your products about 10 years ago. Didn't work for me. I tried it for over a year, and I couldn't figure out why. But now listening more, I'm thinking I just probably wasn't absorbing stuff.
Ah, very good. Yeah, you're more astute than the average bear. Good man. Now, do you have any brothers and sisters?
Yes.
And do they have any health issues?
My brother is obese. My sister has a thyroid problem, mm-hmm. similar to me.
Okay. All right. Well, the fact that you've gone gluten-free, and I would urge you to get a hold of that CD called Cereal Killers and listen to it, because it goes through all the places you'll find hidden gluten. I mean, it's used as a thickener in tomato soup and chicken rice soup, chicken vegetable soup, all the things you think of as being free, that kind of stuff. And then, of course, there's meatloaf and meatballs. These breadcrumbs and bread cracker crumbs in there. My wife got a bag of these mixed nuts the other day, and you read the label on there. So it says allergy information. These nuts are processed, although they're naturally gluten free. They're processed in equipment that does process wheat products, and so just the dust in there is enough to get you. Dry dog food, dry cat food. So if you have dogs and cats in the house, they have to be on canned food. There is one or two foods out there, dry foods made with rice and lamb. You have to use those if you're going to use dry cat and dog food. They have to be made from rice and lamb, although you got to read the label if they're also made on equipment that uses wheat or processes wheat. That's suspect. And so it's very, very important, because just one piece of dust from wheat the size of a dot over the eye on a standard printed page is enough to make you sick for 2 weeks. So you got to really watch it. And, it's a progressive thing. Your intestines get damaged progressively over the years until suddenly you wind up with these eight diseases you've got. So gluten-free diet, absolutely no fried foods, because what do they roll everything in before they fry it? Shrimp, chicken, fish. Wheat, right? Wheat flour. Got to give all that up. They use wheat as a filler in things like salami, bologna, pastrami, pepperoni, all these summer sausage, all these sausage-like things. And then you need to stay away from oils. It means margarines, mayonnaise, salad dressings, cooking oils. If you eat canned fish, they're going to be packed in water, mustard, tomato sauce, not oil, and on and on and on. I urge you to go through the gluten-free aisles at grocery stores. Get a hold of, from your Youngevity associate, get a hold of Valerie's gluten-free cookbook from your Youngevity associate. You'll be happy to have that one if you like to cook. And if you're one of those baby boomers, you're standing on the tracks waiting for those epidemics to run you over. We're not talking about epidemics of swine flu and bird flu. We're talking about epidemics of Alzheimer's disease, obesity, diabetes, arthritis, cancer, heart disease, you name it. These are all things that are doctor-caused. Doctors cause these things by giving you terrible advice, misinformation. And so I urge you to get hold of the book God Bless America and learn how to take care of these different things yourself. Don't wait to get run over by these epidemics, baby boomers. There's 80 million of you out there, and we can save you with God Bless America. Okay, Doug, let's go right back to Pennsylvania and Joe. Well, here we go. We got to deal with the hypothyroidism. We got to deal with the polyuria, which is multiple urinations during the day. This could be diabetes. Have you ever done a sugar test on your urine? Do you think it's diabetes, or do you think it's a prostate problem? Hello, Joe.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, now I can hear you. Do you think that your polyuria, your multiple urinations during the day and the night, do you think this is due to diabetes or prostate problem?
I think it's probably prostate.
Okay, you've actually taken one of these test strips and peed on it and see if there's sugar in your urine or not?
I have not done that, but I will. I've had some blood tests done recently, and they didn't say anything about diabetes.
Okay, so the blood tests were negative. Okay, good. Cravings, which are mineral deficiencies, Allergies should get better if you get away from gluten. Okay, I do need you additionally, because you have low thyroid, to stay away from cruciferous vegetables in addition to all the other stuff you need to stay away from. And cruciferous vegetables, of course, produce sulforaphanes, which interfere with thyroid function. We're talking about cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, and kale. Got to stay away from them. And otherwise, all this stuff won't work. So here we go. 200 pounds, I'd have you take two of the healthy bone and joint packs, two healthy bone and joint packs per month. That's 1 ounce of the Osteo FX Plus at breakfast and dinner, 2 scoops of the Beyond Tangerine Nutri Crystals at breakfast and dinner, 3 of the EFA Pluses in breakfast and dinner, and 15 of the glucogels a day. That's 5 at breakfast, lunch, and dinner. All that will be accomplished by the two healthy bone and joint packs. Then, because you have a history of hypothyroidism, low thyroid function, I'd have you take 3 of our Ocean's Gold tablets twice a day, 3 at breakfast, 3 at dinner. That'll be 2 bottles a month. That's going to supply all the weird trace minerals and rare earths and really weird stuff that your thyroid gland particularly likes. Then I'd have you take 6 of our HGH at bedtime. That's 1 bottle a month. That's designed to give you the carbon chain necessary for your thyroid gland to make the thyroxin hormone itself. And then, because you have a history of polyuria and believe it's prostate problems because you were negative for a blood test for diabetes, I'd have you take 3 of our selenium twice a day. That's 2 bottles a month. Selenium is to the prostate gland as iodine is to the thyroid. Also, I want you to take our ProstFX. Take 3 of those twice a day. That's 2 bottles a month. The ProstFX, it's a blend of herbs from Africa, North America, and Asia that actually support and promote healthy prostate function, size. And then your cravings, I think, should go away pretty quickly here. And I think that's going to cover most of our problems here. Let's go with that. Call me every 2 weeks, if you would, please, Joe, and give me an update. I want to know your blood pressure. I want to know how your polyuria is going. I want to know how your joints are doing. Let me know about your energy and so on. Let me know about your allergies, your cravings. Make a list. Let me know about those things in 2 weeks compared to what's going on now.